Namaste. I am Dr. Narayanan Nambudiri, Chief Physician, Sridhariam Ayurveda Hospital and Research Center. Today, I would like to discuss with you the health concerns associated with the monsoon and how Ayurveda can help in preventing such diseases. Prevention, it is better than cure. That is our motto. Monsoon brings us joy as you say goodbye to the extreme heat of the sun. Along with this happy monsoon, this bring a group of infectious diseases such as conjunctivitis, other ocular diseases, fever, cough, and other many conditions. According to Ayurveda, monsoon marks the movement of sun in the downward direction. Body start to regain its strength during this period. During the rainy season, Vata gets aggravated and results in low digestive power, which in turn lead to improper digestion of food, resulting in the formation of ama, which is nothing but toxins produced in the stomach. And this can lead to many diseases like cough, skin diseases, etc., resulting in low body strength. Viral infections are known to thrive and spread during rains due to increased moisture of the air. And this time, along with the monsoon, there is another villain thriving the whole world as pandemic, the COVID-19. As each day passes by, the microscopic creature is extending its deadly fangs and is literally putting the entire globe to a standstill. Even the developed countries are quite unprepared in facing this pandemic, and the fatalities have raised up to lakhs. Such a pandemic is quite unknown in recent decades, and the world is searching for a solution, either in the form of vaccine or in the form of medicines to boost immunity. Now, the entire world, either it to be a developed or a developing, is practicing the so-called social distancing. In social distancing, we are trying to minimize contact with individuals. As our Honorable Prime Minister has rightly mentioned, we are redrawing the mythical Lakshmana Rekha again around ourselves. And wearing mask can protect two portals of entry of infections, either mouth and nose. But one vital organ is still exposed to the threat of infections or microbes. If droplets fall directly into the conjunctiva, virus succeeds in invading our body, whose probability is quite high when people do interact with each other in common places. Another way the virus gains entry is by touching eyes with fingers or hands after touching a surface of infected area. Recent studies show that virus can survive in fomites for hours to days. Things get quite complicated as transmission is even possible from asymptomatic individuals. The only solution what we have in front of us is to hide from this virus till we develop a weapon against the virus, either in the form of vaccine or in the form of medicines. Ayurveda emphasizes in preparing the body by enhancing natural capacity to fight against diseases. It is nothing but Vyadhishamatvam mentioned in Ayurvedic classics, to enhance our immunity power. Thereby, the enhanced stages that fight against developing microbes inside our system, that helps to prevent such kind of pandemic or bacteriological diseases. Ayurveda emphasizes in preparing the body by enhancing its natural capacity to fight against diseases, to modulate our immunity as required. It provides us with instructions regarding regimens to be followed in a single day, that to be followed in a season, all in view to develop a healthy person, not only to healthy body but also with a healthy state of mind. Now, what is immunity according to Ayurveda? Ayurveda treats patients as a whole. The etiology and the pathogenesis of many diseases according to Ayurveda revolves around the Tridosha theory. Imbalancement of Vata, Pitta, Kapha, these are all the three doshas. The imbalancement of doshas and the consequent impact on the body components are supposed to be the cause of all the diseases. In Ayurveda, microbes are known as Krimi or Bhutas. When etiological factors come in contact with the body, they try to produce diseases. At the same time, our body tries to resist it. The ability of the body to prevent the development of disease or to resist a developed disease is called Vyadhishamatvam in Ayurveda, which is nothing but immunity. It is of two parts. One, which reduces the strength of the disease, those are already manifested, and other, the prevention of those diseases that are yet to be manifested. Immunity is attainable from three sources, that is Sahajabala, attained during the fetal stage, Kalajabala, which is get after the birth, and Yuktikritabala, which is acquired immunity that we get from different food and regimes, etc., which we follows. Ayurveda focus on three plants for acquiring or enhancing immunity, that is Rasayana, is health promoting and rejuvenates the whole physiology, producing resistance against diseases both physically and mentally. Vyayama is exercise, daily exercises up to 50% of one's exertion capacity enhances digestion, strengthens the tissue metabolism and promotes immunity. Satmya is suitability, adapting to whole substances and giving up unwholesome substances to which the physiology has been addicted since birth. There are so many medicines in and around us to immune our body and physique, such as Tulasi. It is very commonly available everywhere. The decoction of Tulasi can be taken morning and evening either with honey or with a little of jaggery. It is good to improve the immunity, as well as it is good for the cough also. And other things like haldi, it is available in our kitchen. One can use this to potentiate or strengthen our immune system. Ginger, it is a good thing. And adathoda vasika, we call it as vasa in Sanskrit. Vasa can be taken along with honey, or otherwise it is, you can take it with a little of jaggery. And other one important medicine, it is guduji in Sanskrit, and giloy. It is very common medicine to the entire India. Ayurvedic practitioners are very commonly using giloy to improve immune system. One can make the decoction of guduji and take, otherwise the powdered guduji can be taken along with water or with other medias, that to helps or to enhance our immune system. And it is also a anti-inflammatory, analgesic. It has got many properties. Not only these single drugs, I mentioned some single drugs. Singly you can use in combination. I told you the guduji, the vasa, the tulasi, haldi, and the combination of drugs also, it is a good thing to maintain our health. And it improves our digestion and improves our immunity power. Apart from following these remedies which is available in and around us, we should follow some special regimens, that is Pathya Apathyas, what to do according to the season. What to do in the rainy season? This season it is a rainy season. And our topic also it is about the diseases which is occurring in rainy season. And the charyas, what to do in the rainy season, we should emphasize on it and we should follow. That helps to maintain our health. And the doshas, as I told you earlier, the different doshas, vata, pitta, kapha, and its accumulation happening. If it is not cleared that time, it will turn to some other vyadhis in the subsequent stages. To overcome that thing, the kind of medicines which I told you earlier, that pacifies the doshas and improves and enhances immunity power. But all the things we follow in jara condition or otherwise fever, the COVID also, it is a pandemic. It is Vishama Jwara according to Ayurveda. Red variety of shali is good to use during the jara period. And the soups which is prepared out of green gram, horse gram and masoor dal can be used. The patient who is having fever should ask to take light food that is easy to digest. Lankhanam paramoshadam, that is what's said in Shastras and in classics. And those who are having fever or associated problems, they should prepare gruel prepared out of broken rice, add on with ginger and a little of haldi. The preparation like khichdi can be used, and yavagu, the preparation, the rice along with the moong dal can be used. These are all good for digestion as well as assimilation. And other than that, yogas, our government also given lot of importance, and the government is promoting yoga and pranayama worldwide. Worldwide acceptance is there. Not only in India, it is originated from India, the people around the world, in Western countries, everywhere the people promoting yoga and practicing yoga to enhance their sattvabalam, to enhance the immunity. And asanas like Surya Namaskara, Gomukhasana, Naukasana, Setubandhasana, Bhujangasana, Salabhasana, kind of many asanas are there to strengthen the body, to improve the immune system, to get away from the diseases. One can practice not only these asanas and many other things. And apart from asanas, one can practice pranayamas also. Nadi Shuddhi Pranayamam, it is a good thing. Inhaling it through one nostril and exhaling it through other nostrils. Sitting in a calm position and doing that when it is a good thing. And other thing like Kapalabhati, Brahmari Pranayama. As we all know, prevention it is better than cure. I told you earlier, there are so many medications. One can practice these regimens like pranayamas, asanas, patyaharas. Even with all these things, the situation, if it is not under control, there are remedies, there are medications in our classics, in Ayurveda, and that you can follow. And the government Ayush department also made some good protocol to prevent this pandemic condition and in fever condition. Jwara, it is of many type. Vada Jwaram, Pitta Jwaram, Sannivada Jwaram, Agantu Jwaram and Vishama Jwaram. This recent pandemic condition, comes under the Vishama Jwara stage. And that also symptomatic, asymptomatic and little advanced stage, many, many stages are there. What to do in an asymptomatic condition? All the symptoms were not manifested. The preparations like Indugantham Kashayam or Giloyi Sattvam can be given. Arishtas like Amrita Arishtam, Vasha Arishtam, Kanakasavam, and the Churna preparations like Sudarshana Churna can be given. And even one can fumigate their rooms with Aparajita Dhupana. It is clinically proven and scientifically proven, the medicine, if we fumigate with Aparajita Dhuma inside the room, the microbial activity it is very less in those area. And in fever associated with mild sore throat, that is the second stage. That is not asymptomatic, it is little symptomatic. There will be some throat irritation kind of problems. So in those condition, first I suggested Indugandham Kashayam. Here we can deviate from Indugandham to Amrutotram Kashayam and other medicines like Vetumaran Guliga, Mukka Mukkadugadi Guliga, Asavas like Kanagasavam, Vasharishtam, and Thalisavatradi Churnam, Gandusham with Trikadu Trifala Kashayam, and steam inhalation kind of things one can follow. And fever with productive cough, those condition, apart from this Amrutotram Kashayam, you can add on Dashamula Gadatram Kashayam, Nayobayam Kashayam, Elaganadi Kashayam, preparations like Agastya Rasayanam, Vyakri Haridagi, Dasamula Rasayanam, all those can be used. Fever, cough, difficulty in breathing, in those condition, that is advanced stage, sometimes one may require ventilation also. Before entering into that stage, one can use Nayobayam Kashayam with Shwasanandam Guliga, Dasamula Gadatram Kashayam with Shwasanandam Guliga. But kind of problems, the giving medicines only one time or two time or three times, it is not sufficient. It need muhur muhur. That means very frequently we should give the medicines. That helps to minimize the accumulation of the kapha dosha present. Ayurveda offers numerous ways to protect eyes. Netra kriya kalpas, it is first among it. And there is lot of therapeutic usages also mentioned in the classics, and that we are following here. And in this pandemic condition, for the protection of the eyes, washing is the best procedure adopted here. You can wash your hands with the soap, you can cover your mouth with the mask, that protects your nose and mouth, but we can't hide your eyes. So for the protection of the eyes, one should follow the cleanliness of the eyes. For that, we should do eye wash, that with the kashaya, the decoction, which is made out of trifala. It is easily, one can make in home. It contains the haridagi, vibhidagi, and amlagi. So the decoction out of that one can pour inside the eyes. Or otherwise, one can take that in a eye wash cup, and they themselves can do eye wash. Not only this trifala kashayam or trifala water, one can do it with a little of coconut, tender coconut water. Add on with one pinch of camphor, it is good. Or otherwise, the kashaya made out of dharvi, yashti madhu kind of things, also it is good to protect our eyes. And there are so many anjanas, collyriums, elanira kolambu, very commonly practicing everywhere in the southern part of India. That cleanses the eyes, but all the accumulated substances present inside the eyes, it cleans and improves the visual acuity. There are so many other preparations. Alam water is a good thing to clean the eyes. Eye exercises are another effective way to improve the overall health of the eyes. It helps in strengthening eye muscles, helps to maintain the vision, maintain the sharper vision, and one can do palming exercises. This one is an easy method. Rub both palms for about 1 minute, and one can keep it over the eyes. Keep it for about 30 seconds, then take it. Again, you can do like that, 3 or 4 times, you can do it. It will be a good and soothing thing for the eyes. Those who are associated with IT job, they can practice this thing in each break. They may be doing some other spine stretching exercises and all. Along with that, they can follow this also to moisture the eyes, and also the massages, like do massage like this one is a good
procedure.
And normally other thing which you can follow, the eyeball movement exercises. We call it as Tradaka Chikitsa, Netra Tradakam. The upward movement, sideways movement, vertical movement, horizontal movement, all these things one can follow. Other than that, sunning, exposing the closed eyes to the sun. Close your eyes and then face to the sun. Give some movements to the eyes. Left side movement, right side movement, upside movement. That others can't visualize your eye movement, but you can feel your eye movements. And it's a good thing for the sharper vision. And also, one should include more of vegetables, green vegetables, fruits, salads, lot of water intake, that to their daily regimens, daily food, for improving good health and free from kind of pandemic problems, and also for the better vision. Thank you all.
Hi everyone. See, always monsoons come with joy, especially relieving the heat of the sun. But at the same time, it always brings lot of problems as concerned with the eyes. See, what are the common diseases that can be affected towards eyes in this monsoon season? We are moving from summer to monsoons. We call it as Ritu Santhi, or the joining of two climatic seasons. And what are the major diseases can affect the eyes? Conjunctivitis, allergic to the eyes, dry eye, stye, which means growth over the lids, and corneal ulcer. These all things can lead to some of the other diseases like retinopathy due to diabetes, myopia, refractive errors, these all things. So what is conjunctivitis? Conjunctivitis is nothing but the inflammation of outer layer of eyes. Always, what can happen is people will be suffering from redness, itching, and watering from eyes. Sometimes some discharge, sticky discharge from eyes. These are the major symptoms which can appear in some conjunctivitis. Basically, this conjunctivitis can appear in two different ways. The first one is the viral conjunctivitis, and the second is bacterial conjunctivitis. Viral conjunctivitis, as we all know, that it's something like an epidemic. It can spread from people to people. Whereas this bacterial conjunctivitis, it comes because of lack of hygiene. There is one more conjunctivitis explained called as allergic conjunctivitis due to some of the external allergic factors. So what can be done for conjunctivitis? Ideally, we say to consult an eye specialist. And for some simple conjunctivitis, some of the home remedies which we can describe, sir. Ice packs for irritation and all. And for redness, and for even to irritation, use the bark of, grind the bark of drumstick plant with butter. That can be applied externally or eyeball or on closed eyes. And next is for decoctions of Nandyarvartam, I mean crepe jasmine. This can be used for washing. These all things can be addressed for relieving the conjunctivitis. Make sure you don't spread the infection towards others. For this, we must say that do not share the handkerchiefs, and please try to avoid going towards the crowded places. Use always alcohol-based sanitizers for hand cleaning, or else use soap solution for always hand wash. These all things can avoid the spread of this disease. One important thing is the spreading can be increased towards looking at the eyes, nor by using the sunglasses. Avoid the usage of contact lenses, going toward the swimming pool usage, and exposure to the chemicals and other allergic factors. These all things can prevent the spread and the aggravation of the disease. Viral conjunctivitis, one important thing is always, most of the time this viral conjunctivitis will be subsiding in a time of 1 or 2 weeks of time. Most of the time it requires no treatment. One of the major symptoms which we always observe in case of conjunctivitis is itching. This can be managed by using the turmeric powder, tulasi leaves extracts. These can be boiled in water, and this boiled water, dip a small cloth in that and apply externally over eyeball, that is over closed eyes. These all treatments can help to reduce these type of symptoms. And Ayurveda says other treatments called Netra Dhara with goat's milk, Aschodana, instilling of eye drops with some medicines, example crepe jasmine, which I was telling you earlier. This Aschodana is, Ayurveda says, this is the first line of treatment in all case of eye diseases, especially conjunctiva is the first disease which affects the eyeball that can lead to some of the other diseases. Apart from conjunctivitis, there is one more disease called dry eyes. See, dry eyes can come in different ways. One of the thing is, it can come as associated with some of the other diseases like diabetic retinopathy, myopia, and other refractive errors. And nowadays, it is more common in people, those who are using this laptops, desktop, all the things for their work. We know that because of the infection spreading, most of the time we are supposed to work from the home through online classes. Students are facing these online classes, and even for the working people, youth, they are working from home. Because of all these things, the tear production and the supply of tear can be blockaged, and that can be managed in different ways. This overstress towards eyes that can lead to other different diseases like refractive errors and glaucoma, etc. This dry eyes we can only manage by always blink your eyes for constant intervals, and give rest for eyes in a gap of some 10 to 15 minutes continuous watching of the TV or any screen, and pouring of hot fermentation with the boiled and cold water that can be applied. These all things can help to manage to some extent in this, especially in case of this dry eye. And always we say to consult a doctor whenever you feel as your eyes are dry, because as I was mentioning here, this can lead to some of the other deadly diseases like glaucoma, which the intraocular pressure, the pressure inside the eyeball, can be some fluctuation in that. So these dry eyes are one of the door which the people's eye can lead to some of other major eye diseases. And Ayurveda says other treatments like Netra Dhara, which is the eye wash, and Aschodhanam, Anjanam, Avagundhana Swedhanam, these all type of different treatments are also explained in managing this dry eye. Coming to the other allergic diseases in this monsoon related diseases, like one is sty, which means a small growth which will be appearing either on the lower lid or on the upper lid. That may be protruded outside sometimes, or sometimes it will be there inside. So what always this, whenever we open close our eyeball, this can touch with the other conjunctiva and all, then people will be facing difficulties like itching, foreign body sensation, something is there inside, they feel like that. And I must say that these styes are always happening due to the inflammation of the other glands like chalazion, meibomian, all those glands which are there. To these all things are helping the even the tears to supply around the eyeball. As this sty concerns, allopathy says excision of the sty, which the inflamed part has to be excised out. But same time, Ayurveda says there are other treatments like Netra Dhara, Avagundhana Swedham, which all these things can, the rooted inflammation can be taken out. Of course, there is a role of some of oral medicines which can also manage this sty. So Ayurveda again says the treatments like Sega or Netra Dhara with the Tulasi, Surasa, and the other hot fermentation with coriander or haridra, and the usage of haridagi terminally, there is one drug with the butter, make a paste and apply externally. These all things can these are explained as one of the managements in managing this or curing this sty. Going to the next is corneal ulcer. The cornea is one of the other delicate organ which doesn't have any direct blood supply. It gets its nourishment through the atmospheric oxygen and aqueous humor. There is a fluid inside the eyeball, and this ulcer, corneal ulcer, can it is a disease which all the other sty, dry, all the things we explained here. These all things can lead to the corneal ulcers, which the ulcer or a tear can happen over the corneal layers. It has got around 5 layers. It can happen, this tear can happen on this any of the layer by doing frequent rubbing, constant usage of this system, all the things while the dry eyes are dry, and this can lead to some of other inflammatory conditions conditions like corneal scar, corneal opacity, which all things which the people will be having more pain due to the increased intraocular pressure inside the eye, foreign body sensation, and of course there will be blurness of vision. That blurness can be either towards the distance or towards the near thing. The swelling, redness, itching, pain, these are the common symptoms which are appearing in case of this corneal ulcer. The other ocular diseases that manifest in monsoons are due to the lack of physical exercise due to the excessive rainy season and all. This can lead to the systemic diseases like diabetes can increase, and due to that there is another disease called diabetic retinopathy. Diabetic retinopathy is the disease which the blood vessels in the vascular layer or the blood vessels in the eyeball that got a breakage, and it can lead over the fundus or vitreous part. This diabetic retinopathy, this manifests in the first line. I was telling you here, like the breakage of the capillaries or vein, and the blood will be leaked out, and this can aggravate towards the nervous part of the eyeball, that is called the retina. And there can be some macular edema, which the retinal layer will get a little bit of swelling. Because of that, that vision can be hampered, and this can other leading to other diseases like retinal detachment and neovascular glaucoma, etc. And finally, this diabetic retinopathy can come in the form of non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy, leading to the macular edema, and next towards the proliferation, which the continuous bleeding of blood from retinal blood vessels or veins. Ayurveda says different treatment modalities in managing this diabetic retinopathy. Urthagada Rektapitta Chikilsa, which means the breakage of blood vessels that has to be stopped, and further bleeding has to be stopped. And next towards, when it moves towards the macular edema, the Shodhahara Chikilsa, then proliferation. That proliferation also should be stopped by using oral medicines and external therapies. Of course, one thing I must say here is Pramehahara Chikilsa. It means the management of diabetes is a must thing here to manage this diabetes. Next towards moving to the eye-related symptoms and signs, Kabhamedohara Chikilsa. And of course, there are some other Keralaya Vishesha Chikilsa like Talapudichil, Takradhara. These all treatments will help to manage this retinopathy, especially in the bleeding vascular layer affected diseases like diabetic retinopathy. As we all know that this diabetes is not a fully curable disease. Even the retinopathy is also, I must say that this is something like a manageable disease. Always when we manage this, we always recommend them to be in a complete follow-up, at least in a gap of some 2 to 3 months. Coming to the other disease called myopia or short-sightedness, it means the something in it near we can able to clear, we can able to visualize very clearly, and something in a distance that will become blurred. This is this comes under refractive errors. Of course, there are different types of myopia like curvatural myopia, simple myopia, axial myopia, and these diseases are also can be managed very well through Ayurveda. Ayurveda refers lot of other treatments, medicines to manage this refractive errors, but it also comes with the usage of oral medicines, external therapies like Shirodhara, Tarpanam, these all things. The first intention or the objective of these treatments are the progression of the disease must be arrested. And see, the one information I must share here is the children always, children are more affected with this. And till the age of 18, maximum by 20 years of age, this can progress. The power of glass can progress. And the progression of the power glass, that must be stopped, and at least the same percentage of vision can be maintained. That can be very well done through Ayurveda. As this monsoon season refers, like we all discussed about dry eye, corneal ulcer, sty, all these things. This, if we didn't manage in the right time, right way, this can lead to short sight or myopia, these of diseases. And myopia, using of power glass or spectacles, it's not a cure for managing this or decreasing the progression or arresting the progression of the disease. And through Ayurveda, if you look, it needs a constant follow-up for managing this myopia. There are three kinds of treatments which are explained in Ayurvedic classical. One is internal taking of medicines, external therapies. The third one is surgically management. And managing all these diseases, both the oral medicines, the intake of medicines and the external therapies will work more. See, the progression of this myopia, how it happens is, always nowadays we all know that we don't get a chance to see in a distance because most of the people are staying in flats, apartments, even children are also not going for outside games because these all outside, I mean, games like cricket, football, all the things are available in a tab or laptop. So people are used with that. So they are not getting any chance to see something in a distance. So if they get that chance only, the eyes will try to function more. This should be keep it in mind. Always there are some other eye exercises called rotating eyeball and moving up, down, and yoga, pranayama, all these other sciences can also contribute maximum to arrest the further progression of these diseases. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu.
Hi, now you have heard Dr. Narayan how to improve the immunity through Ayurveda, and Dr. Srikant talked about that common eye diseases during monsoon time. So let us think about how we can improve or prevent all these diseases during this monsoon. We can start with that Ayurvedic principles, because Ayurveda treats the person as a whole, and it is based on the Tridosha theory, that is Vata, Pitta and Kapha. So Vata dosha accumulates during the summer season, that will get aggravated when the season changes, that is in monsoon. So due to this aggravation of Vata, there is a chances of impairment of the digestion. So the Pitta dosha also get accumulated during this monsoon time, which also this reduces the digestive capacity. So main aim of the treatment is to improve that digestive capacity and to maintain the balance of these doshas in this season. In monsoon, the natural digestive capacity of the person reduces and the digestive power also is hampered. So this can cause the accumulation of toxins in the gut. That is called ama. So this is the main causative factor of that diseases. In monsoon, the water available in the reservoirs will be heavy and it is difficult to digest during this time. So the metabolism will be sluggish and the person will feel loss of appetite. So the turbid water and weak digestive power, both these can cause the vitiation of doshas. Diseases will increase during monsoon time due to the low atmospheric temperature and the climate is very humid. So in these conditions, there is a lot of chances of increased viral and bacterial attacks. So how can you prevent all these things during this monsoon season? So it is important to follow proper personal hygiene and environmental hygiene during this monsoon. That includes proper waste management, cleaning of the environment, cleaning of reservoirs, etc. Other than this, we should take care of our diet, because as I told you, the digestive power will be very much hampered, very much low during this time. So what all things we can follow during this time? The food what we take should be warm, fresh and light. Should not be too heavy. You can include rice, barley and wheat along with honey or ghee. That is good for the digestion also. Include cow's ghee, green gram and honey also in your daily diet. Vegetable soup with sour and salty taste also it's advisable. Food difficult to digest means red meat or curd, it's not advisable during this monsoon season. Usually green vegetables are good, but during the monsoon season, the leaves are more susceptible to insects or worms. So it is better to stay away from leafy vegetables during monsoon season. Milk is very good for the health and it gives more energy. So you can add some turmeric powder, 1 pinch or 2 pinch of turmeric powder, which will reduce that kapha doshas, and that is good to consume also. Avoid uncooked foods and salads. Avoid stale food. That is very important during this time. Yam, sweet potato, pumpkin can be included in daily diet. And ginger also, it's very good for the digestion. Other than this, there is a preparation, especially in Kerala, we have medicated gruel preparing with aushadha kanyi, it's known as, during this monsoon time. So medicines are added and that is boiled with rice and suitable spices are added, and that is good for that health, digestion, for energy, everything. According to Ayurveda, the lunch should consist of all the 6 tastes: sweet, salt, bitter, astringent, pungent. Usually it starts with a sweet taste, or a fruit can be started, then salt and pungent, then end with a bitter taste and finally the astringent. But the dinner should be very light. You should take early dinner and should not be heavy, because it's easily to be digested. Consumption of healthy diet alone will not be enough for that healthy way of life. Along with this, you have to practice some lifestyle modifications. Main thing is that avoid day sleep during monsoon, which can hamper the digestion. And the surrounding should be clean, should not enter into a AC room with wet hair or damp dress. Use fumigative disinfectants like Loban or dry neem for drying clothes and for killing the insects. In classical Ayurvedic texts, there is a product like Aparajita Dhupa Churnam. That is, it's clinically it's proven as its antibacterial effect. Avoid overexertion. The surroundings should be clean and dry. Should not walk in damp water, means, and feet should be clean and dry. Keep the body warm to keep it away from that attack of virus. In monsoon season, the power of digestive fire will be very low and people's immunity also will be very low. So they are more susceptible to diseases. To prevent this, Panchakarma-like treatments are advisable. Panchakarma means elimination therapies that needs some pre and post preparations also. And that should be practiced under the guidance of that physician. This will help to improve the general health and give energy, reduces the chances of diseases, and digestive power also will get improved and helps to balance the doshas also. Panchakarma treatments can be preventive and curative. It can increase the digestive power, improves the channels and clears the mind. In Kerala, we are practicing Karkidaka Chikilsa, which includes the Panchakarma therapy, which is needed for each person, along with this Aushadha Kanyi, that is medicated gruel. Monsoon season paves way to different infectious diseases. In rainy season, there is lot of chances of getting eye irritations like itching, watering, redness, or dryness, or swelling. So to prevent this, you have to take care of your diet also. Along with that, in such a situation, should not touch the eyes frequently. Don't rub your eyes frequently. Don't use the towels of others. Frequent washing of hands. And stay away from plants, because that plants are very susceptible to the insects and worms. So there is a chances of getting irritation. So if there is an infection, anyway you have to consult a doctor for the treatment. But for a healthy eyes, some simple methods or some habitual things what we can follow, it's that is also mentioned in Ayurvedic Dinacharya. That is the daily regimen. What are those simple methods? First one is Anjana. Anjana means application of collyrium inside the inner eyelid. So medicated collyriums are also there, and otherwise you can use even honey as a collyrium. That can clear the eyes, reduces the kapha dosha, and which that vision will be more clear and that irritation will be less. Then next one is Nasya. Nasya means application of medicine through the nostrils. For that also different prepared medicines are there with decoctions or oil or ghee. Even that plain ghee can be used as a preventive method for Nasya. That will clear the nose and improves that sinuses also. Then comes that Kabbalam. Kabbalam means gargling with even with hot water, that is good, or some sesame oil, that is also good for gargling. They clear the mouth and that throat. This will help to improve the vision also. Inhalation of medicated smoke, it's good to reduce the eye pain and all. Then comes that application of paste on face. Different combination of medicines can be powdered, and with suitable base you can apply on with water or milk, you can apply on face, which improves the vision also. Then Aschodhanam, that medicines as eye drops can improve clarity of vision. Habitual things we can follow, it's Abhyanga, that is oil application on head and body, especially that feet, head and ears, which improves the function of Vata, because oil is very good for Vata dosha. That can improve the circulation, even neurological diseases also, that is very effective. So use footwears and umbrella while going out. Use glasses, plain glasses, while traveling. as I told you earlier, stay away from green leaves during that monsoon time. Diet include red rice, green gram, barley, and green vegetables like punanava, bottle gourd, bitter gourd, and also that fruits like black grapes and tribhala. It's very good for the eyes. Mental health is also very important. Mind should be very cool and calm. Avoid over worries and anger. Over emotion should be reduced, controlled. For that you have can practice yoga, pranayama and regular exercises. According to Ayurveda, health is not only the absence of disease, but it is the physical, mental, social and spiritual well-being of a person. For achieving all the heights of life, health is very much important. So one should take more care and effort to protect our health. So enjoy monsoon with proper care for oneself and others. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.